What's up, military millionaires? Today, I want to talk to you about how to apply for your VA disability claim. But first, make sure you subscribe to that channel, hit that like button, and let me know if you enjoy this more general military information right after the intro. I want to make sure that you don't screw yourself over. So before you leave the military, it is common for people to look at the disability claims process through the Department of Veteran Affairs or the VA as intimidating. And I understand that. And so soon-to-be veterans can get scared by the process to the point where they don't even file a claim unless they have really serious ailments. I've heard multiple people talk about this, and that is a shame. And look, to be fair, the process is still a bit shrouded in mystery, and it's not exactly clear how the VA looks at all your evaluations and comes up with a rating for a single ailment. And even more unclear is how they compile all of those together into a total disability rating, right? It's kind of like if you have 50%, 50%, that doesn't equal 100. It's like 50% plus 50% equals, it's a mess. But don't let that stop you, because you need to apply for it anyway. So applying for disability is not weakness, right? I mean, we all have those friends who didn't file anything and then got out of the military and now they've got back problems or knee problems or something else. And it was probably due to the military, and they either aren't on claims yet because they haven't filed yet, or they can't get claims because they didn't have anything in their medical record. It's just way better to take care of all of this before you get out of the military, right? Because it's unfortunate, because if your lower back starts to hurt or your knees or whatever, and you don't have it documented or you didn't take care of it, I mean, you're gonna deal with that for the rest of your life. And just because you didn't go to medical, look, I'm not saying to claim things that you don't rate or make stuff up, but definitely claim things that are real, right? Like, you owe it to yourself and your future family for that. The point is, you are not always going through the claim process for yourself right now. You may just be doing it to take care of yourself further down the road, or be able to take care of yourself so you can enjoy time with your family. We're gonna talk through how you make a claim. Here's what the process looks like. First, you submit a claim to the VA. Your claim can only be submitted within 180 days prior to your separation from the military. Second, the VA conducts an initial review. At this time, they are not making judgments on anything you claimed. They're just annotating it, right? Like, this is the final medical interview or whatever. Third, the VA will then work through a third party to schedule appointments for you to be evaluated. Now, this is important to recognize. The VA is not actually evaluating you. Someone else is. For example, if you claim a mental health issue, you will likely get an appointment for a mental health provider, and this professional will not be in the VA. That person will then evaluate you based on strict criteria from the VA, and they will let the VA know what's going on, right? So it's a little bit of a lengthy process, but there's some checks and balances in there. Fourth, all of your evaluations will be submitted to the VA, where they will determine your rating for each individual claim, as well as your total disability rating. And fifth, you will then receive your rating as early as 2 weeks after you separate from the military. That's it. Not so intimidating, is it? All right, so we're gonna talk through some best practices for success. First things first, it's recommended that you file your claim through a Veteran Service Organization, or VSO. Now, VSOs are authorized by the VA to file your claim for you. They usually know the ins and outs of the system and common problems to ask about. You may think it's just normal for everyone from your unit to have their knees pop when they stand up. It's not a normal thing for people outside of your unit, right? So get a good VSO that can help point out things like this that might be normal for you and your military buddies, but aren't normal for the human body and could result in some disability. So for a full list of approved VSOs, visit the VA directory, and then we're gonna talk through a few more points to take note of. First, it's important to file your claim while you are still in the military. This makes it much easier for the VA to connect your issues with your service. The longer the period between ending service and filing a claim, the more suspect they will be of the claim and more likely to deny or downgrade it. Also, keep track of the mileage for driving to your appointments, as that can be claimed as expenses to the VA, which is actually pretty interesting. I didn't know that. Look, even getting a 0% rating is better than not filing a claim at all. It is better for your future self to have gone to the VA and said, this may be an issue, than to say nothing. Having a 0% rating will at least make a record of it and may help you out down the road, should that issue get worse. To be considered a service disabled veteran, you have to have a single rating of at least 30%. This means that you may have a rating of 10% for your elbow, 15% for your knee, and 10% for the weird GI thing you picked up in Afghanistan, but because it's not 30% for a single issue, you will not be considered service disabled. Right. Lastly, if you feel you were not evaluated fairly or that the rating you received does not truly match your personal circumstances, you can absolutely appeal it. There is an entire industry filled with lawyers and specialists that can help walk you through the process if you think you may need to appeal it. You can also learn more about the appeals process on the VA website, right? Look, you need to do this for yourself. We were all taught in the military to just suck up the pain and deal with it. It's a part of life, and honestly, it's also a part of the culture not to draw attention to yourself and seek personal benefit in the military. Now, because of this, people can be hesitant to file a claim out of fear of being labeled a leech or, whatever. In going through this process, it's unfair to judge yourself and how your body feels against what others are feeling. You don't need to feel guilty for filing a claim for your shoulder just because you know someone who lost a leg to an IED. And that's legitimate. I have shoulder pain. I know someone who lost the leg. Their pain is their pain, and yours is yours. So filing a claim isn't preventing anyone else from doing so, right? Like, this is the abundance mindset. Me having a shoulder injury doesn't mean they're not getting help. The VA disability claim system is there to provide you, and only you, fair compensation from injuries or ailments sustained from your military service. It's not meant to be a handout. Now, do people use it like that? Definitely, but concerning yourself with the actions of others is not going to improve your personal situation. You served your country in some tough places. From that, it is absolutely possible that you picked up some injuries. Whether physical or mental injuries, it is okay to admit that you aren't a flawless diamond. So do yourself a favor and go through the claims process. All right, look, this whole video is drafted from a guest post that somebody wrote for my website. And I liked the article enough and thought this was important enough that I wanted to make a video out of it. So shout out and thank you. I'll put the link down below so you can go read the actual article. He's got the links in there so you can go see some benefits and stuff. But I think this is really important. This helps me out as I get ready to transition into the reserves here soon. And I've been slowly documenting stuff. I wasn't joking about the shoulder. For 5 years, I've been telling the Marine Corps that something's not right with this bad boy. And they'd be like, oh, it's okay. Oh, it's okay. So they gave me an x-ray the other day and apparently I fractured it like 5 years ago. And oops, it grew back wrong. I don't know. So look, going to medical, there's nothing wrong with it. None of us like doing it, right? None of us like going to medical. None of us like missing work. None of us like being broken. But you owe it to yourself. You're only going to get older and things are only going to hurt more. And you don't want to be that 70-year-old saying, oh my gosh, I should have said something. I could have been taken care of. You want to be that 70-year-old who's still able to like smoke check whippersnappers because you did get it taken care of and you can, I don't know, some of those guys are beasts. So subscribe to the channel. Smash the like button or give me a shaka or whatever, turn that thing blue. And if you got something out of this and you want more like VA claim or general military stuff, comment down below. Let me know what topics you want me to cover and I would love to help you guys out. Have a great freaking day.